It's a nightmare that I wouldn't wish on my worst enemy.
That's former Browns quarterback Bernie Kosar explaining his recent arrest and conviction on a reckless operation charge. He sat down with me Wednesday to go over the events of the last few months. Kosar was arrested by Solon police in September for speeding in a construction zone. He was charged with OVI and speed. Those charges were dismissed, and he pled no contest Monday to the reckless operation charge.
It's a nightmare. I mean, explaining this to your children who heard some of the things that were out there, even over the last day or two, to have to explain that to your 17-year-old daughter, to your 14-year-old son.
The officer who arrested Kosar wrote in his report that when he went to Kosar's vehicle, he smelled a strong odor of an alcoholic beverage and Kosar's speech was slurred. Kosar says he was not intoxicated and the slurred speech is due to the concussions he suffered playing pro football.
I had a lot of concussions. There's a lot of physical issues. I'm not looking for sympathy. I'm proud of playing. I love the game. I loved being part of that.
Solon police released video of Kosar prior and after his arrest. While he did cooperate with officers, he did refuse to take a breathalyzer test.
But I've always just been told how unreliable it is and just don't do it. And you know, at the end of the day, I don't feel like I have to make excuses or defend myself on every question. And I just was told that, you know, you just don't do that and they're unreliable.
Kosar added that he has three daughters who are driving and would not drive while intoxicated.
I take it incredibly serious about drinking and driving and the ramifications and things that can potentially happen to yourself or other people. And I wouldn't want to be responsible for being the guy who did something to other people.
He added that he loves the Browns and is disappointed that he won't be broadcasting Browns preseason games this year.
It's so humbling to, you know, to be from here and, you know, to fight to come back and play here, to be living here, and just see the fan support. It's really humbling.